Checking if my mic's on. It is. I believe it is. I have my hearing aids in. Listen to YouTube. It's a trial that's going on. It's kind of cool. I like that. So you can't hear it, but I can. Then I can also hear the plane. Matter of fact, I'm hearing a noise from something. Oh, the switch is on. Wonder if I, yeah, must have, I'm using a different control profile that has the, I have to manually turn everything on without any controls. It's nice for learning to you, or, you know, learning what the cockpit is like. So, I like it. That this has a blue knob, so to speak. That's our mixture button. Mixture. How, alright. This kind of neat, different anyway. It's the flap. It's a weird kind of a switch, isn't it? This plane is probably made before I was born or around there. It's a Beechcraft Stagger Wing. Used to be my favorite looking plane, man. I love this plane. I still like it, but after flying it, I'm not as much of a fan because it's so hard to see out of. It's like one big blind spot. But I've seen some of these. They're like the Cadillac of planes back then. And I've seen some with real Corinthian pelted leather, you know. Remember Roberto or Montalban or whatever it was? Real Corinthian leather, the Chrysler New Yorker seats. And I had a New Yorker. I had two New Yorkers. No, I had a Chrysler Cordoba and then a Chrysler New Yorker. I had an 82 New Yorker, and it was on the showroom floor. Beautiful car. Okay. Let's turn things on one time. This is the battery master switch. And this is the pitot heat. Oh, I got a switch for that. I won't turn that on yet. I'm going to start the engine first. Don't need generator yet. Okay, well, prime. There's a fuel pump. So I don't know why you need the primer. put it on both magnetos, and then we're going to hit the start button. Oh, I got to put... Let me go full rich on the gas. And the gas is on the mains, okay. We'll push the starting button. Oh, I wanted to give it a little throttle too. Okay. RPMs here. Turn the pedo heat on. Panel lights. Dome light. Avionics. Okay. You know, one thing I haven't figured out on this plane yet was how to keep track of the fuel tanks to check the levels. If it was charging, it'd be doing that. I have the generator on, so. Let's see what happens if I turn the lights off. Did improve some. It's almost like it's not even doing anything. Maybe that gauge isn't modeled in very well to represent real simulate. can't turn that off there. Let me try. Cylinder head temperature. That's basically because it's not water cooled, so that's basically your radiator temperature, so to speak. See, without the water, air cools this engine. So running it on the ground like that, kind of, if you'd want to be into the wind to do a run up and stuff. Alright, we're gonna put dial. I'm gonna I had given it a little bit of a throttle when to start it. So alright, we're gonna take the parking brake off, and the view's about as good as it gets. It's not real great. And then I'm going to pull back on the yoke, kind of keep the wheel on the ground. Oh, I took the yoke out of the way. Oh, put the flaps down one. And then just steering it here. I'll get up to airspeed about 40, let the tail come off. Now the rudder's effective. Okay, let's lift off. Now we can bring the gear up. Got some get up and go. I'll bring up the flap. Check the flaps. Alright, let's take a look at our RPMs are up in the red, so we want to bring that down to zero, I would assume, with this kind of gauge. Looks like zero is perfect. I'm moving the prop knob, which is power, or changes the pitch of the blades. Push down a little bit so we stop climbing. So I'm controlling that with the yoke. Alright, now we can get our inches down the manifold pressure. We'll bring that down with the throttle backing out to right there. I'd say that our engines are running within good ranges there. This is suction. This was the carburetor heat. Amps, see, it is charging now.
St. Louis Tower Beach Craft, so, November Charlie, 4135.
And our cylinder head temperature is
St. Louis
about where
November Charlie, 4135 is type
a car radiator would be.
Southeast of Tree Sierra, Quebec,
a little under 200, you know. Might be a little hotter, but 180, I think, is around 182, something like that. Auto thermostat.
Squawk 1354, Beechcraft 135.
Airspeed, we're moving along pretty good. 170, 180, 190, 200, 210.
Cleared through the Bravo Airspace Beechcraft 135.
I'm just banking to the left, so. When we turn in the wind direction, you know, it's changing our, the way the wind is hitting our plane. So we started losing some lift, so I assumed we were going into the wind, and now we're getting more crosswind and actually going to be at our tail, so we'll want to push us down some. Tower that's staffed, and so pilots have to police themselves, announce position, tensions, and then they have some grass fields there too. This wheel right here on this plane, kind of neat. It changes the elevator. Trying one more. Try and make this close to zero and stay, you know, let's say 2,000 feet. So as we get to the top, it's 2,000 feet here. Now I'm gonna roll that wheel so the elevator is more neutral.
Generic November 40724, St. Louis departure altimeter 29.92 radar contact. Continue to Twyla.
Some planes trim easier than others. It's
generic 724, you are 86 miles northwest.
This one is not as
heading in altitude. Expect vectors visual runway 18 right
easy
approach.
As but this bar here, gee man, Chris was stuck about. Man, in your way, this is a speedometer now. It's interesting, this one's in miles per hour, too.
The traffic.
like it should be water, but then it's modeled like buildings. Getting up to 3,000. Golf course. That must be a ball diamond or something there.
Beechcraft 135, you're leaving my airspace radar service terminated spot 1200. Frequency change approved.
Squawk 1200. Frequency change approved, Beechcraft 135. St. Louis approach Beechcraft November Charlie 4135 is type Beechcraft 17 9 miles northeast of Mike Oscar Zero Tree 2600 feet. Request flight following.
Beechcraft November Charlie 4135 St. Louis approach. Squawk 7237.
Squawk 7237 Beechcraft 135.
Yeah. This. This here.
Altimeter 29 decimal 92.
I think that must have something to do with the.
Roger, Beechcraft. Pause this a minute.
That's for the rudder trim. This here, does it show me the different tanks? Function. Looks like a photo cell in there. Maybe it automatically adjusts the light. Right. Hours and minutes required, which we don't have a flight plan, or of course this one doesn't really have a flight plan. So then this be reserve and back to used. It counted up, right? 9.8. Remaining 50. And flow per hour. I don't know how that would. How's that tell me what's in each? Does it tell me? If I go to. 30 and 10, 40. Let's see what happens. That remaining how much is in each tank. Okay. But I have to switch it. So we're on the main. So when that runs down, I'm going to run out of gas. Okay. For that tank. Beechcraft. Stagger. Yes. Pretty, isn't it? The inside is got like a, you know, 350, 450, 350, does have some guidance Garmin equipment. This was the trim for the elevator, and there's the fuel. The inside's not as impressive as the the outside. Well, that looks that sure looks like the one in the flight simulator, don't it? They went 300,000. I wouldn't have been surprised if it was more, but it's a 1943 plane. $253, I don't know. 3GX holds 172 gallons, so Razorback fuse. Everything's works. IA owned. Cared for. Air show history. Located near Boise, Idaho. Now that would be more what I would expect. $750,000. Been more updated. Pretty. Something I probably wrecked. My hanger. So V-tail.
San Francisco Tower Beechcraft Golf, Bravo Sierra Victor Hotel at runway 28 right, ready for departure, departing straight out.
Southwest 1182.
5740, line up and wait. Japan Air 58 Heavy, go around. Line up and wait, SkyWest 5740. Going around Japan Air 58 Heavy. Pac Coast 55, contact NorCal departure on 135.1. Good day. Japan Air 58 Heavy, contact NorCal approach on 134.5. Good day. Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel, leaving my airspace frequency change approved. Southwest 1182 number 2 for landing. Follow the twin jet on final. Wind calm cleared to land runway 28 left. 134.5 Japan Air 58 Heavy. Goodbye. San Francisco Tower Horizon Air 2041 at runway 28 left ready for departure IFR to Sky Harbor.
San Francisco Tower Beechcraft Golf, Bravo Sierra Victor Hotel frequency change. NorCal approach Beechcraft Golf, Bravo Sierra Victor Hotel, is type Beechcraft Bonanza 4 miles northwest of San Francisco 3,000 feet. Request clearance to transition Bravo airspace.
Southwest 1051 descend and maintain 4,000 feet. Beechcraft Golf, Bravo Sierra Victor Hotel, NorCal approach. Squawk 2207. Descend and maintain 4,000 feet southwest 1051.
Squawk 2207 Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel.
Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel radar contact 5 miles northwest of San Francisco 3,100 feet. Cleared through the Bravo airspace.
Cleared through the Bravo airspace Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel.
Southwest 1051 descend and maintain 3,000 feet. Descend and maintain 3,000 feet southwest 1051. final approach SkyWest 3302 is missed approach at San Francisco. SkyWest 3302, you are 1 mile southeast. Climb and maintain 4,000 feet. Expect ILS runway 28 left approach via sit-by transition. Clear to sit-by. device is at 7,900 feet, descending 5,000 feet. Savavia 5 NorCal approach altimeter, 29.9, 2 radar contact, continue to GRR.
Sierra Victor Hotel request taxi to parking.
Beechcraft Golf, Bravo Sierra Victor Hotel taxi to general aviation parking via taxiway Foxtrot 1 cross runway 01 left Foxtrot 1 Bravo Delta cross runway 10 right Delta cross runway 10 left Delta Charlie.
Taxiing to general aviation parking using taxiway Foxtrot 1 cross runway 01 left Foxtrot 1 Bravo Delta cross runway 10 right Delta cross runway 10 left Delta Charlie Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel. Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel.
4401 request taxi to the gate. Frontier flight 4401 taxi to gate Echo 10 Victor using taxiway Echo Bravo Delta Alpha. Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel, continue taxi.
Good.
Roger, Beechcraft Sierra Victor Hotel.
Roger, United 700 Heavy.
St. Louis approach pits Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf Sierra, is type pits 1 mile southeast of St. Louis 800 feet. Request clearance to transition Bravo airspace.
Pits Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf Sierra, St. Louis approach. Squawk 6727.
Squawk 6727, pits X-ray Golf Sierra.
Pits X-ray Golf Sierra radar contact 1 mile east of St. Louis 1,700 feet. Cleared through the Bravo airspace.
Cleared through the Bravo airspace, Pits X-ray Golf Sierra.
United 2432 climb and maintain 9,300 feet. Keep speed not above 280 knots. United 2432 is at 10,000 feet climbing 11,000 feet. United 2432 St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact. Continue to flood. Pitts X-ray Gulf Sierra contact St. Louis approach on 126.5. Good day.
126.5 Pitts X-ray Gulf Sierra. Goodbye. St. Louis approach Pitts Alpha Sierra X-ray Gulf Sierra 3,200 feet.
Pitts Alpha Sierra X-ray Gulf Sierra St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact. Continue.
Contact St. Louis approach on 124.2. Good day.
Bohemia Zero contact Kansas City Center on 121.25. Good day.
124.2 Pitts X-ray Golf Sierra. Goodbye. St. Louis approach Pitts Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra 2,600 feet.
Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact continue. Pitts X-ray Golf Sierra contact St. Louis approach on 126.5. Good day.
126.5 Pitts X-ray Golf Sierra. Goodbye. St. Louis approach Pitts Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra 2,400 feet.
Pitts Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact continue.
Contact Kansas City Center on 128.1. Good day.
Air France Zero Heavy. Goodbye.
Coyote 404 is at 10,300 feet, descending 2,400 feet. Coyote 404 St. Louis, approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact. Continue to Horus.